Alright guys, so back with another mower. It's the latest mower I got. Had it for a while, but I finally went and picked it up. I threw this together yesterday. That's the hood that's supposed to go with this mower. And the hood that's on here, the mower, let's see, mower's about a 80 something model, I don't know, somewhere in there. Hood's off a 70s model, 1136. Mower itself was a 1236. So the motor that was on this thing was just slammed wore out and wouldn't run. So I popped this John Deere 19 and a half overhead valve on it because I had this thing laying around in the mower that mower actually. And I dropped it in there yesterday. And another reason I just wanted this hood on here because it looks better than the old hood. But one other reason is that hood was not going to fit at all without doing major changes. And this hood, all I had to do was cut out that piece right there for the HOV valve cover right there to stick through. And then it lined up pretty much perfect. I had to use, I don't know if y'all can see or not. I don't think y'all can see in there, but like right here is the old hood mount hole, and there's just a random hole like this up here. That's what this is going through. So I just had to run my holes a little farther up, but it fit. And I didn't switch over my key switch or anything. I just hooked up the old one that was on this mower. So if any of y'all put a newer motor like this, and your carburetor's got one of these, it's a fuel. I think I call it a fuel solenoid. This deal plugs into the bottom of this. And all it does is when you turn the mower off, it shuts the fuel off so that, you know, you won't flood the carburetor, which is dumb because these things have fuel pumps. So you ain't turning the mower over, it ain't sending no fuel to the carburetor. But all I gotta do to bypass those, unscrew this, and there's a little rod. And what that does is when you cut off the mower, sends that rod up and shuts off the fuel. So if you take and pull this out and grind off that rod, like this one had a rubber tip on it, just took a pair of pliers and ripped it off, then that'll solve that problem. Or you could, you know, if you want to keep all that electronic stuff, you can switch it over, but I didn't want all that. Pretty basic controls over here. Nothing really works. Key switch, throttle, 7-speed. I got the Max Auto catalog came today. It's got a tractor seat my buddy put on it. I'm going to put a ball hitch on the back. I might have to make a deal to come out for that because I think it's going to be too close to mount one there. But it's a pretty cool little mower, 7-speeds. Right now, you know, it ain't super fast or nothing, but thinking about doing a pulley swap, but I just had everything laying around and didn't really want that John Deere. So, threw this together yesterday. The original headlights were busted, and these are just some fog lights I found in a barn that happened to be the right size. So I screwed them in there, and I painted this black just because I thought it'd look good. As you can see, I don't have a muffler right now. I'll show you, this thing shoots blue flames. Painted the wheel yellow because for some odd reason I had one wheel that was just gray. But what I'm doing right now is greasing these axles. Ain't nobody greased them, and I don't like to run them dry. It wears out. They don't really have bearings in these wheels, but it'll still wear your wheel out quicker. It'll wear down the metal track or whatever you want to call it that these run on. So I always like to grease these up with a good bit of grease. Just gonna keep her going a little longer. Lined up here. Spins a little better. So that's just what I'm doing with that. Let me get that done and I'll come back and I'll show y'all it running in the flames. Alright guys, got the wheels put back on. There's the one I painted, it was gray. Got those put on. Got to find a new wheel. This one wobbles and slides around. But anyways, fire this thing up. It's going to be pretty loud, but let me find my screwdriver. I don't have a cutoff switch yet. There it is. Alright. Loud 19 and a half horses with no muffler. You can see it better when it gets dark outside. You might can see it in the video, but out that little pipe there, it shoots flames. But so that's the new Murray. I think I'm gonna call it the Frankenstein Murray, since you got a John Deere motor, a 80s frame with a 70s hood, and then don't even know what, probably an actual tractor seat on it. So that's the beast Frankenstein Murray. And if I do anything else to it, I'll make another video, but that's probably all I'm gonna do to it for now. Looks pretty badass, so yeah, thanks for watching.